The president has been clear that he does support raising the age of to 21
as federal policy
for certain firearms.
That is Deputy White House Press Secretary Raj Shah on ABC's This Week with Jonathan Karl. The president's proposal for gun basically his gun control proposal is out. It's not containing, among other things, legislation to raise the minimum wage for purchasing assault weapons from 18 to 21, though it's going to be one of your favorite things from your legislative days, C4, studied by a commission.
Absolutely. But what I think the president has decided to do, particularly since the Florida legislation, Senate Bill 7026, became law, signed into law by Governor Rick Scott, and immediately after it, Robert, it was challenged in court by the NRA.
It was.
What the president has said through tweets, now we got to go by this because he didn't actually say it on camera, is that he is waiting for the adjudication of that lawsuit to really deal with the issue of 18 to 21, because the NRA is directly suing the Florida law now based on the raise the age 18 to 21 issue.
And it should be noted that the president never said, I support this. I said, I would consider it.
Well, he was a little stronger than that. Words. He was a little stronger
you would
than
parse,
that.
But you have to parse the words here because the NRA goal, and others get
absolutely.
Defensive.
Absolutely. But the real goal of this that I see, reason Secretary Betsy DeVos has been appointed the head of this thing, Robert, is that he wants a commission for a year to really study school safety. Yes, gun control issues as well, but school safety, and really determine some of the things he talked about, like teachers being armed in schools, the increase of security in schools, whether it's locks or metal detectors, all that
right.
stuff. So I look at what he is doing so far as the fact that he's put the 18, 21-year-old thing on the side for a minute, which I think should be raised because there's already a handgun. You can't buy a handgun
right.
unless you're 21 years old. But I think he's waiting for the Florida thing to work itself out.
That's something
courts.
That would certainly sell in if Maryland wanted to do it, if the General Assembly
absolutely.
Wanted to do it in the remaining weeks. The other thing the president wants to stress is mental health. And this is
yes.
something that both sides have said, you know, it's been ignored. And
well,
really
here in
has
Maryland, Governor Larry Hogan's $125 million proposal, we talked about it with him last week. A large part of that is going to be within schools to help with mental health counselors and everything else to really identify young people very early, Robert, to determine whether there are issues that need to be dealt with in terms of mental health. So I think all states around the country are recognizing that, and it's a money issue. It really is a resource issue. How much money are we going to devote to something this serious?
I want to shift gears for a bit. We're going to have a little fun in this remaining minute. I want you to hear something.
$3,160. There they go! Ho, ho, raise your son!
That is a clip of part of our childhood. Duck pins and dollars. And as to note, yesterday was the 70th anniversary of WBAL-TV signing on. This was one of the many bowling shows they did in this very building. They had a four-lane bowling alley.
Yep.
Employees were encouraged, I'm told by some of the old-timers here, employees were encouraged on their lunch break because they had to keep the lanes in condition.
Well, one of the hosts, at a certain time I told you, Royal Parker, who was very well known for a variety of things he did at WBAL-TV, including
yes.
the duck pin bowling.
And he was an anchor and he was a kid
Hilton
show host.
Elementary School in 1960s. He came to Northwest Bowling Lanes to support, it wasn't a TV show, but he himself came to support this elementary school, Hilton, and he was a huge star for all of us. So I will say this on the record.
Yes, sir.
Robert Lang should be the next host of Duck Pin for Dollars.
I have told...
I'm putting that in
I
right
have
now.
Told previous general managers here, I have not told Jan Jarosz, but I told Jordan Wertlieb and Bill Fine, if you ever install the bowling lanes again,
you got my
I'm
vote,
auditioning
Robert,
for the host.
I told you before, you're no Royal Parker,
oh,
but
absolutely
you're second
not.
Best.
Absolutely
second
not. I would never be a Royal
Thank
Parker.
Thank you, sir.
C4, don't forget the C4 encore tonight at midnight, and C4 is back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.